What is the preferred approach to oxygenation? As a general approach, we target a peripheral oxygen saturation between 90 and 96% using the lowest possible fraction of inspired oxygen. We suggest selective use of non-invasive measures rather than routinely proceeding directly to intubation. Among the non-invasive modalities, we prefer high-flow nasal cannula over non-invasive ventilation, unless there is separate indication for non-invasive ventilation, e.g., acute exacerbation of chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, heart failure. We have a low threshold for intubation in patients who have any of the following: rapid progression over a few hours, failure to improve despite high-flow nasal cannula more than 50 liters per minute and fraction of inspired oxygen more than 0.6, development of hypercapnia, and or hemodynamic instability or multi-organ failure. When mechanical ventilation is required, we use low tidal volume ventilation targeting less than 6 milliliters per kilogram predicted body weight range, 4 to 8 milliliters per kilogram predicted body weight that targets a plateau pressure less than 30 centimeter water and applies positive and expiratory pressure. For patients with COVID-19 who fail low tidal volume ventilation, prone ventilation is the preferred next step. For those who fail low tidal volume ventilation and prone ventilation, alveolar recruitment maneuvers, inhaled pulmonary vasodilators, and, rarely, extracorporeal membrane oxygenation are considerations.